Please aid me in welcoming our commencement speaker, Mayor Chokwe Lumumba.
Good morning. President Bynum, I agree with you. I think we can do a little better than that. Good morning. It is truly an honor to be here with you all this morning. I understand that this occasion is not so much about me as it is your babies, so I promise to be brief in my remarks. I think somebody's with me now. As I stated earlier, it is truly a privilege to be the commencement speaker this morning. As I begin, I would like to first express my gratitude and recognize President Bynum. This esteemed platform this esteemed panel of platform guests, the faculty and staff, the students, and most especially, the 2018 graduates of the I Love. I am truly honored to be selected as your commencement speaker this morning. As many of you are aware, last year's commencement address was provided by former First Lady Michelle Obama. And this year, you have me. Won't last year's class be jealous? It's okay, you can tell them that it was actually Drake that gave you your commencement speak. We'll keep that little secret, all right? I get that all the time. As I stand before you this morning, I'm struck by the realization that the future of our city, state, nation, and the world depends on the individual and collective genius that you all possess. I'm proud of each and every person that will walk across this stage in a few minutes. My hope is that you are able to fully experience the joy of this day and make memories that will last a lifetime, for you all deserve happiness and success. To the parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, and family members that stood by the graduating class to help them get to this day, this is your day as well, and you deserve a round of applause. When I consider the beautiful occasion that is before us and what it must mean to each and every one of you, I cannot help but reflect back on my college experience and my graduate commencement. I graduated from college in May of 2005 on Mother's Day. And unfortunately, it provided a bittersweet occasion for me because my mother passed the summer prior to my junior year. It was a day that she often spoke of and was looking forward to attending. My mother was the first person to truly believe in me, often boasting that her boo-boo boy was brilliant. My father, on the other hand, needed a little more convincing. As you are cloaked in the joy of this moment, you must be able to discern that your success does not belong to you solely. There are many people, both known and unknown to you, that are vested in your achievement. My father once stated that our talents are not ours alone. They are the fruit of our labor as a people belonging to us all, and they must be used accordingly. Today, your names will be added to the Jackson State University alumni scroll, along with individuals who have made a lasting impression on our world in the domains of health and science, in education, social change, and even professional athletics. You share a common thread and experience with these giants, and you have a common call to make your impression on the world. To arrive at where you are sitting right now, I recognize that there have been obstacles along the journey. We all confront very real challenges. But it is what we do in the face of these challenges that truly defines who we are as individuals and as a people. As unique as you are, the experiences that you have had during your undergraduate tenure has been just as unique. To truly appreciate the beauty of this occasion, we must take a moment to recognize the struggles, challenges, and complexities each of you have experienced. For those of you who have had to work 2 and 3 jobs just to pay for school, when it felt like you did not have enough energy or time, your decision has allowed you to overcome these economic challenges. And today, you should be proud. For the students who did not think that college was for them and labored over the decision to drop out, the encouragement you received from family members and friends, professors, and ultimately yourselves led you to this milestone. Today, you must be proud. For the students with families that depend on them, who had to make choices of whether they would come to class or go to that important function, whether they could afford that book or afford that babysitter. Today, your dedication and love has brought you to this very moment, and today you should be proud. Whether or not your car broke down, or you didn't have enough money to eat, or to get a ride to work or school, had to make a decision over whether you would finish that assignment after you had to start all the way over after a technical malfunction. Whether you had to deal with a sickness while lacking health care. You've had your support systems, your support networks. You've had your faith, you've had a legacy of role models who have provided a roadmap for you, have fought for you, and have filled you with the love that has allowed you to overcome your obstacles and prepared you to extend yourself in a life of service and love just as it has been extended for you. You have become well aware of the challenges and obstacles of attaining your degrees. And you know through personal experience that you must be devoted to unearthing the root of these fiery trials. It will take your brilliance, your fortitude, your empathy to transform the conditions which give rise to these issues. We must all dare to confront the systemic inequities that inform our condition. And we must unapologetically center students and the future at the core of this sacred work. Dr. Margaret Walker Alexander reminds us that our basic institutions of home, the school, and the church are threatened by the same violent destruction that undermines our social, economic, and political systems, for they are part and parcel of the same whole. How we approach our educational practices in these times of political turmoil and systemic disregard for Black people reflects the long-standing mission of our institutions. As a proud HBCU grad, I believe in sustaining our institutions because we deserve to absolutely self-determine our learning and our lives. As soon to be alum of this great institution, I challenge you to consistently support the I love. Give me a round of applause for supporting the I love. I challenge you to support it in your giving, in your contributions, not only to the institution, but your contributions to the community. Our institution should lead the social transformation. When the world seeks solutions to complex issues, it should be able to find the scholars and activists to solve them right here. Our institutions are marketplaces of ideas, and it must take our collective genius, and it must be our collective mission to change the world from right where we are standing. In a city with a population that is 85% Black, that houses 2 major HBCUs, and boasts of a Black municipal leadership, the brightest futures of our communities should exist in this space more than anywhere else in the country. We need your genius to achieve this. Today, your graduation not only solidifies your future, it is the promise of our progress as a city and as a community. It is my hope that as the excitement of this accomplishment settles in, that you will take the time to truly and fully reflect on who you are and what your impression must be on the lives of others. When you look around the nation, the age of institutional and organizational leadership is rapidly becoming younger. And that also means that you are poised to be great and impactful with every decision that you make. Your time to change the world is not coming. It is now. Many will suggest that you are simply too young, and others may even question the sincerity of your efforts. The reality is that every modern movement for change in this world has been anchored by young people. Critics will be afoot. Criticism is something that we can avoid easily by saying nothing, doing nothing, and being nothing. You can't allow praise or criticism to get to you. It is a weakness to be caught up in either one. Remember to resist the urge to pop off at any cynic or contrarian who tries to bait you on Twitter. Don't worry about the person questioning you in your comments. The critics are doing their job. You must focus on the work and do yours. Recall the wisdom of Malcolm as he reminds us that if you have no critics, you more than likely have no success. As young black men and women, never forget that you live in a world where you are still in danger. It is a sobering reality that your degrees cannot shield you from injustice. But you hold the potential to change the world far beyond our wildest dreams. We must fight against a seemingly endless cycle of poverty and exploitation. We must demand that no one be brutalized in the streets, the workplace, or public spaces. As the nation turns its focus on high school shootings from coast to coast, I long for the day where, as black people, we have as many rights as a gun does in this country. We are not in need of any more doctors, lawyers, engineers, educators, or business owners who are seeking only to increase their financial status. You will need resources in order to support your vision, but the money cannot be the primary motivation to work hard. Let the lack of others, the blatant inequities of the world, be the force that fuels your ambition. Today, I hope that those who would dare marginalize and oppress feel a little less powerful because you are being released into society armed with your intellect. I stand ready to fight with you to ensure that our brothers are no longer gunned down in the streets. Our sisters are treated with the dignity and respect that they deserve. Our young people have access to empowering opportunities, and our communities reflect the beauty of the people that make them so special. As I prepare to take my seat, I offer you the words of the brilliant author, psychologist, and revolutionary, Dr. Frantz Fanon. He proclaimed in his book, The Wretched of the Earth, that each generation must discover its mission, fulfill it, or betray it. That is a powerful charge. That is a powerful charge that each generation must discover its mission, and either fulfill it or betray it. I believe that you represent the era of disruption that must dismantle the status quo. This is the generation that will shift the paradigm that has tolerated incessant poverty and conditions which treat people less than human beings. Gone will be the days where we exist in political spaces where people have no power to truly control their own lives. This will be the generation that declares that we no longer want to be governed. Instead, we want to be governor. Thank you very much, and congratulations to the graduating class of 2018. God bless you.